This lesson will focus on one of the quintessential problems of linear algebra. Given a set of flat geometric objects, such as lines and planes, what are their common intersection points? In the abstract, it isn't immediately obvious why this problem has much interest outside of pure mathematics. How do the intersections of lines and planes come up in real life? Geometric objects are often defined to be sets of points whose coordinates satisfy a particular relationship, like an equation. For example, this ellipse in the plane is the set of all points x, y that satisfy the equation 1/4 times x squared plus 1/9 times y squared equals 1. And this shape in three dimensions, called a hyperboloid, is the set of all points x, y, z satisfying the equation x squared plus y squared minus z squared equals 1. Flat objects, like lines and planes, satisfy a special type of equation called a linear equation, in which the only operations allowed are adding and subtracting variables and constants, and multiplying variables by constants. So, for example, x plus 2y equals 1 and y over 2 minus 2z equals x are linear equations. But x squared minus 1 equals y is not linear, because x is being multiplied by x, and y over x equals 3 is also not linear, because a variable y is being divided by another variable x. In real-world situations, these equations typically come from observed or modeled relationships between quantities. Let's take a look at a modified example from machine learning for trading. Suppose I'm trading stocks, and I have a choice of two stocks, A and B, that I can put into my portfolio. Let's denote the proportion of each in my portfolio by WA and WB, which are weights between 0, meaning none of that stock is in the portfolio, and 1, meaning that the portfolio is entirely that stock. Note that WA and WB have to add up to 1, since any portion of the portfolio that isn't A must be B. This gives me the linear relationship WA plus WB equals 1. Each stock also has an associated metric called its beta value, representing how correlated its price movements are with those of the overall stock market. The beta value of my portfolio is a weighted average of the beta values of its individual components. So, if the beta value of A is minus 1 and the beta value of B is 2, then the beta value of my portfolio is WA times minus 1 plus WB times 2, or simplified, 2WB minus WA. Having a beta value of 0 means that the portfolio is uncorrelated with the market, so it has minimal market risk. Suppose I want to choose my weights so that I minimize market risk. Then that means I need the weights to satisfy the equation 2WB minus WA equals 0. This gives me a second linear relationship between the weights of the stocks in my portfolio. In other words, I now have two lines. Finding what values of WA and WB satisfy both equations, in other words, finding at what point the two lines intersect at, tells me what the weights of the stocks I choose should be in order to minimize my portfolio's market risk. Often, variables are factors that are within our control, but which we want to set to correct values in order to satisfy some constraints. In the previous example, our variables were the weights of the stocks in the portfolio, and we had two constraints that we wanted the weights to satisfy in order to achieve some goal. Interpreting this problem in geometric language, we created two lines and we wanted to find the point where they intersected. What we created is called a system of linear equations. Finding points that satisfy all the equations at the same time is called solving the system. In practice, this is how problems involving the intersections of geometric objects come about. These types of problems show up in fields as diverse as economics, biology, chemistry, physics, engineering, and of course, computer science. In this lesson, we will use our tools from the first lesson on vector operations to solve this ubiquitous problem of finding intersections.